And it's hard. One morning at 7:30 in the morning, I got a phone call, and John came into the room and said, "There's somebody on the phone that wants to know about Yosa's health." And I was talking to somebody, and he said, "Oh, is your son, does he have any health problems?" And I said, "Oh, not really. I think, you know, from time to time, he doesn't feel too good." And they went on, and I couldn't tell what was happening. And he said he collapsed, and I asked about his vital signs, and they said, well, he didn't have any vital signs. Apparently what had happened is he had worked out at the gym with a friend, one of his co-workers, had a good workout, and then he'd gone and talked to a few people, you know, on his way, which is what he did. He never just sat down at his desk. He always talked to a few people. And he sat down at his desk and he started answering the emails that the company was getting, asking questions about the product. And he was in a cubicle, and he was talking to somebody in another cubicle, and they said they heard him give something like a snore, which we know now is a very classic sound that people make. And the woman was talking to him and didn't hear anything for a short period of time, and then went over and he was collapsed. And they started CPR, and they called the paramedics, who were quite close, but he was never brought back. And he died. His overall health was fantastic. He was 6'4". He was, I think, about 180 pounds, 175 pounds. So he was, you know, he was in good shape. His cholesterol was 126. He was a real health fanatic. He watched what he ate. He didn't eat a lot of fats. He had a good diet. He worked out religiously. He worked out at the gym. He bicycled whenever he had a chance. He'd take people out at noon and walk them around where he was working. So his health was outstanding. I mean, there never was a health problem that we could see. I mean, he saw doctors regularly. Young people don't get the exams that they should have once they leave their pediatrician, and that isn't until they're in their 60s and 70s that they get absolutely everything they need. So his doctor hadn't really done any kind of an exam. He had done track and field in high school, and he had also swam, and he was a big runner. Before he did track and field in high school, he'd never had an EKG. He'd never had his heart looked at. We did have some heart disease in the family, but we didn't even know that was an option to have his heart examined, but he never did. SCA is so common. I think it's common in young people. I mean, it seems like every week there's another couple of cases that we know about. And the other thing that's not brought up, and I've had this theory for a long time, you hear of unexplained drownings from good swimmers. That can be SCA, or somebody, we know of several people who lost their children while they were mountain climbing. Well, if somebody dies while they're mountain climbing, nobody is going to do an autopsy. And sometimes it's impossible. If it's a chemical problem, you're not going to find out what happened. So a lot of times, or there's an automobile accident when the road is clear, there's no drugs in the system. What happened? And then they say, well, it might have been suicide. They don't know. So I think that all of these accidents that many, not all obviously, but many accidents that happen to young people are undiagnosed SCA. Thank you.